guys, welcome back. Here's another quick late night video to sleep to, I guess. As my work begins to pick up, I'm starting to have less and less time for fan art, but as usual, when I went for a warm-up sketch, this sketch of Gladstone that was meant to be 20 minutes tops turned into something like a 3-hour drawing because once I got going, I was in the flow and I didn't want to stop. This keeps happening all the time. That's why it takes me quite a long time to finish personal original projects because I literally keep getting distracted by my warm-ups and putting too much time into them. I know someone's gonna tell me, don't draw fan art as a way to warm up then. Yeah, it's easy to get consumed in it, so just do the more typical warm-up exercises everyone talks about, like blind contouring and drawing circles and stuff. Well, drawing fan art puts me in the right headspace, especially if I'd been so busy I hadn't properly drawn for days. It really helps set me mentally. Those of you who work a full-time day job unrelated to art know how hard it can be to get back into the swing of things. Drawing circles or doing contours or any of the other warm-up just doesn't do it for me, and it only leads to me procrastinating. Of course, disclaimer, do not be like me. Those warm-up exercises are popular and widely used for a reason. They do work, just not for me and my situation. If I had more free time and more control over my schedule, I'd probably have done some of these exercises more often. Anyway, a few quick notes on my drawing before I get more into the video. This was meant to be a super quick sketch on my iPad. I'm using the Procreate app instead of my regular sketchbooks to get more used to the feel of drawing directly on the screen. I haven't drawn Gladstone in over a year, and so I wanted to get back to it, and I prefer his general aesthetic, art style, and personality from the comics way more than his DuckTales 2017 counterpart. Gladstone has a lot of interesting interpretations and explorations of his character in the comics. If I were to overgeneralize what his character archetype is, he's his cousin Donald Duck's closest rival. Although he often passively-aggressively antagonizes Donald in the comic books, it's usually framed to be a consequence of Donald's actions and an outcome of him getting caught up and consumed by his own feelings of failure or jealousy. Donald's meant to represent the average person, the readers, whereas Gladstone's meant to represent someone lucky in life and gets what they want. However, one point I respect about some of the stories I've read is that Gladstone and his good luck are almost never framed as villainous. He's mostly a neutral character, often hovering towards the side of good. In some stories, the more aggressively Donald embraces his resentment of Gladstone and tries to best him in one way or another, the harder he falls. Of course, Duck comics are just meant to be light and funny, but sometimes there's a deliberate reflection of real life in some of these stories. If someone is meant to have something good come to them, if all the people on the planet banded together to stop that person from getting what's meant for him or her, they wouldn't be able to stop it. Someone like Scrooge is far more pragmatic, and he understands this. Rather than stew in jealousy or feel too annoyed, he utilizes Gladstone's luck in helping him find treasures and places. Several times, the rest of Donald's family would admonish Donald for being too hard on his cousin, who never asked to be born so lucky, that's just the way he is, and that he's as deserving of love and companionship as anyone else. Grandma Duck and Daisy Duck seem to be the characters who initiate this conversation the most often. One of Gladstone's most obvious character traits in some of the stories I've read is that he's very generous, and the fact that he does it without anyone looking shows you that it's genuine, not for the clout. He gives things away freely, with very little thought as to where his next meal ticket will come from. Some would say, yeah, well, that doesn't really make him a good person. He's lucky because he never has to worry about money ever. That's an extremely unfair thing to say. That's like saying the charity of a wealthy person is worthless because they have money, whereas the charity of someone who's relatively poor is intrinsically so much more valuable because they're not rich. These ideas are toxic, and if one's honest with themselves, they come from a place of jealousy. People's good deeds don't lose intrinsic value because they're more successful or because they're wealthier. While it's true Gladstone doesn't go out of his way to go out into the world and make it a better place, which is a pretty big character flaw in itself, but it doesn't put him in the villain category in any way. Like I said, he's portrayed as a very neutral character in most of his appearances. a neutral character who genuinely loves his family and genuinely loves Donald despite happily annoying him with his luck. Laziness and having no long-term goals or ambitions isn't his character arc struggle though. It's people taking advantage of his luck and objectifying him to the point even Donald finds horrifying. Personally, I think playing with this character struggle in the DuckTales 2017 would have given Gladstone a lot more depth and plenty of interesting character dynamics and plotlines. In the episode The Phantom and the Sorceress, we do get to play with the idea that he's being used to find something important, but that idea's dropped before it can even be explored. I get that the show writer's idea of him was to make him a foil for Donald and to give people the character that they quote-unquote love to hate on, but I can't help but be disappointed by the lost potential of the complex character from the comics we never got. If you're a Gladstone fan and would like to read some comics focusing on him, I really advise you to read the scanlations of The Secret Gardener, Oh Lucky Man, and The Lucky John Doe. Those are all on my Tumblr blog, and I'll put links to them in the description box. These are three of the ones I translated myself, but there are some other awesome stories as well. After you've read some comics, I recommend you to check Mott's Tumblr account for her Duckverse fan comics, which are fantastic and some of my favorite content ever. I'm gonna leave a link to that blog in the description as well. One last thing I want to say, because I don't want this video to get any longer, is that people like Gladstone do exist in real life. One of my friends has a friend who knows a real-life Gladstone, only without the attitude, but his friends even nickname him Gladstone. But here's the thing. These people are usually some of the most down-to-earth, humble, and sweet people you will ever meet. Their wishes are simple, they don't ask for grand things at all, nor do they want clout or fame or power or massive wealth. This friend of a friend, God protect him, knows he's blessed and he's extremely grateful for it, and he's always telling his friends, "Please stop telling people about me, you're gonna jinx me." People like this guy do exist. Talk to enough people and someone will know a person who gets everything they ask for, but they're usually simple people who don't attribute their good fortune to themselves at all, nor do they want a whole lot out of life. It's an interesting thing to think about because in many stories, Gladstone actually doesn't want a whole lot out of life. The thing he wants the most over and over is companionship and respect for him as a person and not because of how he can be someone's radar to finding fortune. So that's it for me guys, thanks for tuning in, this means a lot to me. If you'd like more videos like this from me in the future, let me know and subscribe to the channel. My goal is to reach 100 subscribers in 2021. Sounds easy, but it isn't. And of course, follow me over on Tumblr to chat. Let me know if you'd like me to create more Duckverse videos in the future. And stay safe!